Today the wife and I are heading down to Newport, Rhode Island to check out some old mansions. If we can get there.
John's Adventure Vlog.
Hello and welcome to John's Adventure Vlog Hotshots. I am Jonathan Paul here in the Fiesta with my wife in southern Connecticut. Literally and figuratively running on empty. This fuel gauge has said 0 miles to empty for the last 10 miles. GPS, tell me where a gas station is. And it's like, it's okay, John, there's a gas station 5 miles away. Except there was no gas station there. Google Maps lied. There was nothing but a field.
We did it. We found it.
It was a good 20 miles of road without a single gas station.
If I had a dollar for every time I pulled into a gas station when that said 0 miles to empty, honestly, I'd probably have like 15 bucks or so. It happens more often than I'd like to admit.
For you Fiesta owners out there, when it says 0 miles to empty, rest assured, you got like 10 or 15 more easy. The reason we're driving in southern Connecticut is because yesterday, the wife and I went to the Foxwoods Resort Hotel and Casino. So, you know, we got to see a comedy show, had a nice Italian dinner, I did some gambling. It was a fun evening. We've been to Newport before. That was the second ever John's Adventure Vlog, in fact, where we went to a haunted mansion in Newport.
All right, so we're on this picturesque dirt road now in the middle of Rhode Island.
It's a nice road, though.
Yeah.
You know, Google told me to avoid this and just go around and do a couple blocks north, but fuck that shit. This road's awesome.
Pretty cool.
I feel like we're driving through a nice, like, national park or something. Hear all those noises? Those are the Native Americans taking shots at us with their BB guns.
You white folk, get out of our land!
Over the ridge.
On our way to Newport, we decided to stop off here in Jamestown, a small peninsula just west of Newport. And I'm standing now on a sandy beach overlooking the Atlantic Ocean because in a week's time after Hurricane Sandy comes through, this entire whole city's probably just about wiped off the planet. So I thought, why not take in this picturesque view and the nice, clean, salt water air? You'll enjoy it. Because it probably won't be here in like a week. At the terminus of the Jamestown Peninsula is Beaver Tail Point, and here is where we find the third oldest lighthouse in America, aptly named the Beaver Tail Lighthouse, overlooking the Atlantic Ocean on pretty much all sides here. And it's nice to take in these sights and appreciate this lighthouse, which will be most assuredly destroyed in just a few days' time when Sandy hits. You saw it here last, folks. Established in 1749, destroyed in 2012. Out in front of the lighthouse, here we have some noble construction workers who are working day and night to already start rebuilding the lighthouse. They will give their lives to save this monument. We have reached our destination, the Elms Mansion, here on, I don't know, Mitt Romney Boulevard in downtown Newport. I'm impressed. Anytime the door itself weighs more than you do, it's probably an expensive building and it's worth checking out. So concludes our tour at the Elms Mansion here in Newport. It's your typical early 20th century, $30 million mansion. This is the super elite. This is the 1% of the 1% that lived here. They only occupy this 7-room, like 20,000 square foot mansion 8 weeks out of the year. It's opulence at its finest. A nice little leisurely stroll through the upper bedrooms and through the marble bathrooms. And the people that lived here, just like, oh, I'm rich. Let's get 400 of our closest associates over for dinner. We'll have all of the Mexicans and blacks in the kitchen cook dinner for them. But make sure no one sees them, because that would be a faux pas. Further down 1%er Avenue, we find ourselves at another mansion. This one, known as the Rose Cliff.
I'd buy that for a dollar. Leave a comment below if you got that reference.
And so we exit through the gift shop of the Rose Cliff Mansion. Really beautiful place inside. Long hallways with the red carpets and the giant windows and the private libraries. The costumes and the wardrobes. One of the fun facts we learned inside on our audio tour is that these socialite 1%ers used to change their clothes up to 7 times a day for their yacht wear, their tea party costumes, and their afternoon driving. And I'm thinking to myself, 7 times in one day? That's more than I changed in a week. We also learned that besides the 1974 Great Gatsby film that was filmed here, the ballroom scene from True Lies with Arnold Schwarzenegger was also filmed here. Like, I'm sitting in the room going, okay, yep, that's cool. Wait, with True Lies, hello. Got my attention. Love that movie.
The audio kept mentioning the Preservation Society, the people that make these mansions available to the public today for a low price and the tours. And every time they said Preservation Society, I kept thinking to myself, oh man, I love that Kinks album.
It's time the wife and I were gonna go get a nice dinner and then head home. So unfortunately for this video, that'll have to do it. Thank you as always for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.